Since the unexplained interruption of the webcast executions, no information of the captured American soldiers has surfaced. Has instated a complete media blackout regarding diplomatic negotiations between the U.S. and China. Authorities warn of the very real possibility of Georgian mercenaries releasing falsified news reports. The possibility that China was in any way involved in the still unconfirmed execution of American soldiers. In the hope that the crisis can be averted before leading to world war.
Chinese part 2, which they didn't mention for whatever reason, continued maybe, I don't know. It was Fisher's plan initially to grab Feirong and interrogate him, but that seems to be a little more important this time around. Anyway, I digress. Yangon, Myanmar, November 12th, 2004, 0011 hours. Wait, didn't his... I think his Muksobo mission ended post 1:30 or around that time. Or maybe it was 11:30 in the night. I'm not sure. Maybe it was 23:30. Anyway, discover President Nikoladze's secret. Following the rescue at the slaughterhouse, Feirong prepares to flee the embassy with a near-complete nuclear device. The only hope to prevent war between the US and China over alleged Chinese support of Kombayn Nikoladze is for Third Echelon to find proof that Feirong is acting alone. Basically, whatever the...
We'll make this fast, Fisher. We need proof that Feirong represents a splinter faction opposed to the Chinese government.
Am I still on leash inside the embassy?
Not at all. You're fully authorized to use lethal force. Fifth freedom with everybody, except Feirong. We can't risk killing him until we've got proof. We're done with politics. This is war.
Ooh, a war to prevent war. So greetings for the Woodlings. Welcome back to some more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. Yeah, let's talk to her.
This is as close as we get. Lambert's worried about spooking Feirong.
We'll make it work.
Do good, Agent. I don't want to go to war.
Really? Really, Colin? Anyway, there's a nice little shadow here. Let me just go ahead and save it. You don't need... technically, you don't need to save it here. I just like to save it at the start of the game for good luck, you know? You can call me superstitious that way. So there are two paths you can take to go... where you want to go. We basically want to go get inside a kitchen which is supposed to be somewhere around here, and yeah, you can go through the back door, which is gonna make things a little more difficult, or you could go through the front door, which ironically make things simpler. And just make sure that you're crouch walking when you enter this cafe. So this is basically the front door. You want to enter in like a customer, just be a little sneaky about it, don't like go talking to the guards and stuff. And asking them how they are.
What if it detonates on the way?
The colonel told me that's impossible.
Why? Everything's in place.
But it's not armed. It's actually a very delicate machine.
It's still possible.
Quiet. Just eat your food. We have to be ready to go in a few minutes.
Yeah, they say that, but they never really get up from there. Another quick save here. I mean, that guy won't be noticing me, but just, you know, just for the heck of it. So, as you can see here, as you can't see here, but you can see from the lighting indicator, you're in complete shadow. Nobody will notice you right now. So, there's that guy in there. He's just going to keep, you know, rotating between his dishes. And what you want to do is basically go when he's not looking in your direction. And you want to be slow about it. And, yeah, he does that weird sort of bit sometimes. Anyway, so quick save here. I'm just gonna go ahead and open this door. Really? The door opened on its own? Yeah, let him just come over to this side. Let him just turn over. Oh, didn't notice me. That is always good. That was a simple part. Up above is the more difficult part.
Fisher, you're going to have a whole mess of keypad locked doors to get around, and we won't be able to count on captured intelligence for the codes. You'll need to improvise.
Okay. Improvise, I shall. So, the reason I quicksaved here is because there's a person right up here who's going to notice us. And maybe we can get a look at him when we... put on our thermal goggles, maybe we won't. And now the problem is, this place is a little too well lit, and I'm not sure whether I was supposed to take this light out before I came up here. Because right now, yeah, see, so right now this guy's coming over. You do not want that happening. You want that guy going away. And there's also like a narrow beam bridge which you want to cross. So patience is pretty much the key here, or so I would say. Let's try this again. Maybe going this way might help. Hey, guess what? It worked. So just come out here gently. And where you're looking to go is this. Yeah, you basically just climb this pipe up. Climb up this pipe. And just go down this path here. Don't stop here, make sure that you turn this corner first so that you're safe from his flashlight. And yeah, once you're here, now you're safe. So basically you can go ahead and save here. Whoopsie daisies. Can't I like climb up here? Don't really worry about those guys downstairs, they won't notice you. I mean, technically you can... Actually, you do have to drop down. At some point. At this point, specifically. Anyway, just hurry. Your entrance is right here. And that's where you drop down. You might feel like, ooh, that's a trap, as in... You're not supposed to go down there, but yeah, that is where you're supposed to go. I don't know why I'm saying it like I am, but yeah.
We've got an idea for the keypad locked doors. Go ahead, Grim.
The average temperature in the embassy might be cool enough that you could sense a heat difference on the keypads.
It's worth a try. These doors are our only way forward.
Okay, so whatever you say, sir.
Got enough. We've wiped the last of the data speed. We're moving on to hard drive.
Okay, so this is basically where you need to rush a little. I mean, not too fast. Just make sure that, you know, you're stick up against the wall here. And where are we going now? Oh yeah, this pipe. Completely forgot about it. Now, things can get a little messy right here. So it's highly recommended that you make a quick save here.
What? It's in a thousand pieces!
They can retrieve data from the fragments. The drive must be wiped and broken.
Yes, sir.
Throw that!
And that's basically how you do it. Realistically. How you do it realistically. Because typically how you're supposed to do it is... like, not typically, you can just practically... You can exploit a bug in the game. And all you need to do is just... No. Boop. Yeah, just shoot out a light and they'll go ahead and try to investigate where it came from and they'll forget all about the data here. Anyway, I'm just gonna grab the satchel here and we'll head on with our life and mission. Okay, communication archives from the embassy server in the basement. Basically, another way of doing it is... you can also just head right up there. And so the reason I took care of the lights was that these bodies would now be hidden. Otherwise they wouldn't be. So yeah, just recovered from satchel. You can try using these computers for extra data if you want. It doesn't really matter. The door is right here. Let's just go through the door since we broke the window. Ha ha ha. Pretty funny, aren't I? So, yeah.
Graham, how does it look?
I don't know how much of this we can use. They've wiped clean most of... Lambert, take a look.
Oh, dang. We just found the missing americium 239. Back in a second, Fisher.
Okay, so basically that's the computer that you're looking for. You can just, like, if you're doing a speedrun or something, you can just practically run up to the computer and use
it. New objective, Fisher. There's a convoy of trucks in a warehouse on the embassy grounds. You need to make sure they never leave. I know you're not equipped with enough explosives, but...
But anything with a full tank of gas is a bomb waiting for a fuse. Do I need to worry about radiation?
The components aren't assembled. It won't trigger anything nuclear.
Awesome. So, with that being said, let's head on.
This is Kong Feirong. Relay condition red to all troops. Repeat, condition red. Nikoladze has abandoned us. All men to full alert. I want that convoy ready to move.
I can hear somebody moving about. I don't know who it is, but I can certainly hear somebody moving about. Let's see, I think we were supposed to go through this way. I don't remember right now. Maybe we were supposed to do something back here, maybe not. Probably not. Yeah, we won't. Alright then. I'm just gonna look, peek through. Ah, yes, this part. So, up ahead is. It's a little difficult. You might want to save here. Maybe I saved a little too late. I shouldn't have saved there, perhaps. So basically, there's a guard standing right there at the door, and you want to walk past him. Now, how you do that is a pretty good question, to be honest. Let me just go ahead and try using this diversion camera on this guy to perhaps...
It doesn't make sense.
As you can see, Sam Fisher's right there. Maybe this was a little horribly timed. But at any rate, I seem to have found my window, and I shall exploit it quite ruthlessly at that. Yeah, let me just go ahead and... Okay, so noise isn't an issue. It's just our movement speed, basically. We want to move slower.
There's nothing here.
Good, good, good. Good observation. Come on. Perhaps we can wait here a little longer. And just to stay out of this light here. And quickly switch to the shadow here. And this shadow shall be our ally for days untold. Let's move. Let me just quick save here nonetheless, and let's get a move on. Maybe I'm moving a little too slowly. But hey, it seems to work. So what the hell? It doesn't really matter, does it? So I'll just wait for this guy to pass. You know, I feel like a proper genius right now, because I executed this so well. And what we want to do here is... basically try using this keypad, exit, and enter this room.
Sheng Yang, we'll be pulling out soon. Relocate your patrol to the main hall.
Yes, sir.
I'll just create another save here. Basically, you need to be a little quick at this point. Yeah, you hear that?
Use the thermal goggles, Fisher. They should allow you to see the heat signatures on the keypads.
Yeah, once they pass, just come over here. Use your thermal goggles. So basically the reddest ones are the ones that are more recent. One, two, and I can't tell which is older here. Come on, come on, come on, fade away, come on. Because you two look exactly the same amount of old here. And I can't tell which one is which. So basically it was 1, 4, and 6, 3? Nope. Okay, let's try 1, 4, 3, 6, yeah. So basically they were all equally hot, and I couldn't tell which one was which. So basically what you... Oh shit. Okay, so you could like literally just walk in right now and nobody would bat an eye, to be honest, but yeah. You could do it this way as well. But what you're really waiting for is this door to close. Maybe I should... Nah. I should just wait here for some time. Yeah, so that we can get behind this cover here. And that's that. Let me just create a quick save here. Yeah, just let it pass away and then we'll jump, I guess. Yeah. Just stick to the wall here. You should be good. There shouldn't be anybody above you. And you can like literally get out at this point here. And I'm just gonna... And hopefully this guy won't see me this time around. Further complicating things like that. Come on man, you should know better. Actually, not this gun. Yeah, let's try this pistol right here. Come on, you can do it now. Let me just go ahead and quick save here because this is a pretty nice and dark spot. Okay, that seems to have worked. And let's hope that it keeps working.
I have an official order for this.
There's no time. I have to...
I understand, but this is the only time. Show yourself!
No, I do not think I will. I wonder what's illuminating me so much. Come on then. You're not supposed to look here. Come. Here we go.
Is your safety off?
Of course it's off. Why would it not be off? So I guess I sort of rushed back then. So let me just go ahead and save here. So basically this entire sequence you need to be a little quick. Yeah, let's try it this way. It's a good thing I'm not actually making walkthroughs because those would have been... Damn, those would have been difficult. Just grab this and blow up this light here. That should keep the distraction going for longer. And take the general in. Sorry, the colonel, not the general. What am I even saying? And once the door is locked, nobody's going to be able to get inside. So it's pretty fine, even if we just dump the body here. We're just going to take this light out for extra measure nonetheless. The door is closed right now, so it's not like anybody can enter this place. And know that the, you know, this dude's body is right in here. I'm just going to, yeah, use a computer here and... Oh yeah, we got a data strip from the previous computer as well, didn't we? I'll just go ahead and read that in the next section. So you want to slide this thing open and basically just climb out. You basically want to drop down right now, but I'll just take a moment to update a save and read you guys a few data sticks because I know you guys love me reading those. From redacted to Vyacheslav Grinko. Dr. Jones, it's an encrypted message. Demolitions, munitions, though I don't know how, man. CO assembling his own device from materials recovered from our Third Echelon Peninsula. If you want... I guess that's an encrypted message for you. From Ko Sang Chen to Som Ok Wong Samung. Are those names Chinese? They sound a little more Thai to me for some reason, like Southeast Asian instead of like, you know, Chinese? Laos Passage. Wong Samung. We've been abandoned by Nikoladze. We're pulling out sooner than I thought. We're being forced to move before we're ready, but at least we're going on the attack rather than sitting around babysitting these wide-eyed punching bags. We have contacts enough to make it through Thailand with relative ease, but Laos could be another story. Colonel Tohoi is coordinating passage points at borders and needs corruptible contacts inside the Laotian military. And that might not be so difficult. I figured you were the man to ask. Money won't be a problem, but time is near zero. I've got the sat phone. You know the number. Chen. Back to the game. So. And that's how you start the next level. Now, there are a few ways to go about this next level. I'm just gonna start this next level off with a save. Did I just screw myself over here? I suppose I did. Anyway. Let's see how that'll be able to. So this is guy right here. He's coming over, and we do not want him to come over. This is actually the first time I've been using these thermal gear, sorry, surveillance gear in this game. And I just remembered that we do have them. I do not really think you can. Oh, we can! That's amazing, really. No, there isn't anything here. You're fooling yourself. Come. Come. Just look at the night sky, man. It looks so pretty, doesn't it? Yeah, that's right. Let's go back there. Yeah, so that might have... Yeah, that did us a little bit of a favor. It might be easier sneaking over to that side now. Okay, let's do this again. And this time, let's be a little quicker. Excuse me? Shadows, please. Thank you. No, you did not. Yeah, perhaps I should have saved it. And yeah, let's just take the time to save here, I suppose. Not like we can do anything else here. And... Boy, that was... That took a little bit of acrobatics. I wonder how people who can play this game better than I do it without them. Let's see if anybody cares. I mean, I do remember this mission having a lot of moments like this, which, well, just weren't worth it, but I guess it is what it is. And let's just get out a ring foil round, I suppose? Nope. Well, that does the trick. Huh, that's a pretty fast camera, isn't it? Actually, it isn't. It's pretty slow. And it's a good thing that it doesn't surveil the area that we are trying to head to. Excuse me. No, I do not think I will take the object. All non-essential transmissions to channels 9 Really, no. Well, not that you would need the medical kits a lot in this level, but these next few sections you just might. So yeah, basically just make sure you go here. And I'm just going to quick save right now. And let that guy see me. Like an idiot. Yeah. Excuse me? Can I jump, please? Thank you! Why am I going through all of these things again? Why am I jumping through hoops like a monkey again? Yeah, so basically it's the same logic here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that 1, 2, 3 wasn't the code was something else. You had to use the scanner to read the code, basically. And there's a lot of ammunition and stuff here which you can really use. Nobody really comes back in here, so you can take your time being here. It's a safe space, you can save. You can update your saves in this location here. 556. We can use that. And I think there's also a medical kit. And there's some 572 ammo, you know, so that you can shoot out all the lights everywhere. And let's see here, what else do we need for our little preparation? I mean, we can practically just switch the object right now, and that will draw him in. There are like three different guards right here, which you need to worry about. So, okay, lesson number one. Do not place a wall mine there.
Who's there?
Nobody need to worry about, sir.
It doesn't make sense.
Come in, come on. Well, that's that. Wasted two of my A-foil ring rounds, but I guess that works, I suppose. Huh. Anyway. We have another guy here who we do not want to serve for the record. And that guy doesn't really give half a shit. So I guess I'm just gonna quick save here. See the American commander, I wonder. Okay, so if you take a look upstairs, where is it? Ah, yes, the camera is right there. So basically there's a camera there, and we need to be able to, well, not use it. Not let it see us, basically. So, yeah. Okay. So that seems all correct. Nobody saw us. We could probably use a diversion camera to get over onto the other side there. We also do have a tool right here which allows us to disable cameras, but the problem with this tool is that you need to keep holding it like this, and it only works on cameras, not on lights. So good luck with that. It's unlike Chaos Theory, where you can like just, you know, take the camera and do whatever you want with it. Just don't bring it over here. Yeah, nothing like that. Yep, that seems to have worked, actually. Next up, distract this guy so that I can cut through there, because I'll just point it out to you guys. So basically, on the left, the second, what do you call it, entrance right there, the second standing place, that's practically what we're aiming for. Nope, Would you like to move, sir? Ooh, 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 that was close. Easy, slow there. Another problem is that you need to do wall split jump when you're up against that thing there. So, yeah.
There is nothing here.
There isn't, is there? Told you there was nothing there. Well, let's hope that guy doesn't see me when it does. Okay, time to equip this and point it at the camera and start moving. And make sure that we are over here in the shadows when we let it go. Because right here what we need to do is climb up onto this thing and do a split jump to reach the side. Basically. I did not see any enemy troops on camera, son. What are you talking about? Let's let it make its pass over there.
What was that?
Nothing for you to be concerned about. You go ahead and take care of your own business. Come on. Huh. So basically this is our way ahead, and once we get up there we won't be harassed by these guards anymore. You need to make sure that you're at max speed when you do the jump.
What's that?
And make sure to keep the C button pressed as well, unless you, you know, literally want to. Well, you did. You know what, let me try shooting the slide out, maybe that'll help.
The lights!
Yeah, the lights are gone, aren't they?
That's
enough, finally.
Man. We've got more than enough fuel on board, and we need to get moving, okay?
Come, no need to rush here, it's a pretty, like, what just happened? Anyway, just keep your sniper rifle out, and, I mean, it's technically not your sniper, it's just a rifle that you're carrying around. And what you need to do here is, you need to aim this, stand up basically, aim this, not that, yeah, you need to zoom in and you need to aim the sniper at the patrol gun thing. Like I said, there's no need to rush, nobody will be coming for you. It's just that is just for dramatic effect to show the state of panic that you said about. And yeah, let's just hear what Lambert has to say, then I'll proceed.
Kirk Fisher, those nukes aren't going anywhere.
Now the general.
Right. We think he and his computer both are in the ambassador's office. You'll need Feirong alive to access his data.
Okay, so now that the rushing part is done, our entrance is right down there, and I'll be right back. Alright, we're back, and you practically don't need to rush like this. Let me just go ahead and check whether there was something over here. I do not think there was. Maybe some health kit? I don't know. Huh. Nothing here. Anyway, so all we need to do is just open this trap door and drop down. And the next part is quite full of stealth, to be honest. Just stick in between these things. I'll not waste two of my... yeah. On him. and just prefer to proceed with a shock bolt instead. Come, back into the shadows. Yes, this is where you shall lie. And yeah, just I guess enter here. There should be a general which comes along. If he hasn't yet, it's fine. No need to panic. See, right here. So come on,
I need help. The general is trying to kill himself. Where are you? His office. Hurry!
So basically, just create a save there because you're gonna need it. No need to rush too much. Just like wait around the corner. Because this guy is going to be looking at you. Come. Yeah, so wherever... You basically need to follow him and make sure that you're not noticed by him. Because you need the keypad codes. Yeah. So you can go now. And... okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. The code was 1, 2, 3, 4. So basically, blue represents the lighter shade, while I probably should not have quick saved there, but okay. Blue represents the lighter shade, green is slightly warmer than that, and red and orange are the warmest. So basically, what we're looking for right here is whichever key was pressed first, that's coldest, and whichever was pressed last is the warmest one. And that is basically how you know which key you want to press. For example, right here. This. Nope. Okay, again. This. See how this faded away first? And that is basically what you're looking for. No need to worry about this here. Okay, 1, 2, this. Fine. And just open this door, and before you enter, just make a separate save here because you're gonna need it. And the first time around, it might be a little overwhelming for you, but yeah, it's not really that difficult. No need to worry so much about it. I can already hear something burning, and I do not like that. So I'm just gonna create a quick save here, and we have the general there. Now some people like shooting this light out. I don't. Let's try without doing that.
Going to shoot myself.
Not in the face.
You are American. You are the cause of all my sorrows, yes?
Yes.
Perhaps you will do me the favor of killing me.
Okay. That was a pretty roundabout way to, grab him. I don't know why I couldn't grab him when I was behind him. So yeah, basically, what we want to do now is interrogate
him. I'm going to unlock the data in your computer, and you're going to help me.
Go to hell! You can't force a dead man into anything!
You're not dead yet. The rest of your life is all you've got, and how painful that is depends on your cooperation.
My life was suffering long before you got here. Do your worst!
Will do.
So basically, one of the reasons it's so easy to grab him is because he's drunk. But yeah. And the poor chap dies.
Fantastic work, Fisher.
I see more suicides on this job.
Grim, how does the data look?
Solid. This completely separates Feirong from the Chinese government.
Fantastic. Get the relevant stuff to the Joint Chiefs. We'll forward the same to China through the CIA. Fisher, we're done in Myanmar. Meet Cohen and get the hell out of there.
Okay. Why is there a body here? Oh, okay, this guy. Alright, so where's the explosion? I see.
Damn, we lost control of our document fire. It's already passed up.
Why? Why you gotta do that to me, man? So yeah, just slide this open and... just drop out there, and I don't really know where you want to go from here. Oh yeah, that's the Osprey. Okay, come on. Oh, that was that level was a little long, but I enjoyed playing it actually. I mean, this is the first time I'm using all the stealth concepts that I have in trying to stealth through this level, and I think that's why I did a comparatively good job, especially with the doggy section. The next section also has a doggy section, and I think the one after that will as well. And anyway, moving on. Chinese Embassy, Yangon, Myanmar, November 12th, 2004, 02:24 hours. Took a bit of time, around 2.5 hours, I think, or maybe 2 hours, I'm not sure. With proof of Feirong's rogue status, the US and Chinese restored diplomacy. Meanwhile, the hunt for Nikoladze turns back to Georgia, where intelligence gathered in Myanmar indicates he left behind the key to a mysterious weapon known only as the Ark. A weapon he is willing to risk a return to Georgia in order to recover. And I guess that's where we're going, to Georgia. So, basically, yeah, the plotline is a little straightforward for this Splinter Cell. There isn't a lot of covert stuff, just, you know, get to locations, intercept signals, find evidence, nothing really much to make of it, to be honest. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty nice. This level in particular, it's again one of those stealth levels. You can play it by knocking everybody out. You don't need to do that, however. There are a few people that you do need to knock out, I think. I think there are ways to bypass that as well. Because I think I've seen PS2 players doing that. This is the PC, so I don't think I can do that on the PC. Another thing which I did was I just got my CDs, my PS2 CDs, and I'll probably be making a video of the nuclear plant as well, and just sandwiching it in between Kalina Tech and what's the next level? Chinese Embassy, just to give a continuation to the story. So yeah, that's that. Anyway, so basically the next level, we go full circle all the way back to, what is it again? Georgia, yeah, Tbilisi, Georgia, and we'll be infiltrating the president's palace. So that's that. That would technically, typically be the final level of the game, but for our intents and purposes, we actually have three bonus levels since we're on the PC, since we're on a platform which is not the PS2. There are three bonus levels which have been released for us, because the cutscenes and the cinematics and storylines, they vary a little. The PS2 is more like a James Bond style spy thriller, while the other versions are a little more like, well, Tom Clancy like spy thriller. So anyway, so we'll have three extra levels. Those will be dealing with Philippe Mas and the last of the arcs, whatever they are. Anyway, so, I mean, they did give you a hint in this level. If you're smart enough, you can grab onto that. If you have played the game before, if you know the plotline already, if you look it up on Google and want to give yourself a spoiler, you can look it up and understand that anyway. But, yeah, so that's that. And until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.